Well, hey, Rob, I want to thank you for taking the time to join
thank
us
you.
Today at the Bridge. And we just want to do something like this to make it available to those who are not able to be in our service today. But the district has launched Antioch College.
Yep.
And you're helping, actually leading the endeavor, so to
that
speak.
That is correct.
And
yes.
What's really valuable to me is that this is biblical training that is fully accredited, mm-hmm. that people can engage in. And so we just recently became a partner site.
Yes.
And would you just kind of share some of the things you did in the service and maybe even just a little more detail? Because this is really critical to me as a person. And I think it has long-term implications, not just for our church, but other churches. So why don't you share a little bit more about what you shared today?
Absolutely. Yeah, there's a few different things that we're trying to all bring together in Antioch. One is a bachelor's degree, as you talked about, that gives accessibility to students online, but also brings community
yeah.
as well. So that's where the partner site concept really comes from, is that the Bridge, and we are actually now up to 20 partner sites that are a part of. We're very,
awesome.
Very excited. So students can learn online, but in the context of community and boots on the ground. And so we're excited about this model. We are not trying to compete with other schools and universities that have lots of majors. We want to do one thing and do it really well, and that is offer a bachelor's in ministry leadership and see future pastors and missionaries and all types of faithful leaders emerge out of this school. And so we've made a lot of changes, you know, obviously with our classes are 8 weeks long, for
okay.
example, the partnership with the churches, and the ability for us to hone in and do that one
yeah.
thing really, really well. So that's a little bit about Antioch. One of the questions I get asked all the time is, okay, who is Antioch for?
Right. Who's your target audience?
Who's the target?
Yeah.
Obviously, we want to have this emerging generation really respond to the call of God on their life and to pursue that. But in addition to that, we are seeing individuals maybe in that 35 to 45 range that are saying, you know what, I've had a sense of calling for years. I'm looking at the second half of my life and want to pursue that. We actually have a 55 plus scholarship.
Yeah.
And a gentleman
yeah.
in your church came up to me and asked
yeah.
if you had any scholarships for 80-year-olds. And I said, well, we have a 55 and up scholarship. He said, do I get more if I'm more on the plus side than the 50? And so, yes, we're seeing people that want to maybe take some Bible classes and firm up that foundation. The other exciting piece is we want to catch folks very, very early on. So if you are 16 or older, you can enroll in what we're calling early college, okay? So you fill out the application. It's only $25. You have a pastor's reference, a little essay that you write. And when you enroll, you are available to take any of our freshman or sophomore level classes. And the first class is completely free. It's on us. You don't have to go to Antioch then for your college. That will then give you a college transcript. You transfer that. But after that, all of the classes are 50%
wow.
off. So if you're 16, 17, 18, are interested, that is a great way to start getting some college.
So how does somebody who's interested in this go
yeah.
about, what's somebody says, I'm interested. First
yeah.
step is?
First step, antiochcollegeag.edu.
Okay.
I'll say it right into the camera. antiochcollegeag.edu. That's our website.
Okay.
You can read all the courses. I mean, it's got
right.
more information than you would ever want. You can get the application process going, and our director of our admissions, Amy Peel, will then
okay.
contact you to begin walking you through, because you can transfer.
Okay.
You have transcripts that transfer in. We've had folks that already have a bachelor's degree in something
yeah.
else that want to pick up a Bible emphasis. And we even have something that's called life experience credit.
Yeah. Okay.
You can fill out. And so lots of ways for people to get. But that would be the first step. And then our team will run with getting you through the acceptance process. We have rolling enrollment. So with our 8-week sessions, there are 6 different times during the year that people can begin.
Okay.
You know, you have the fall A session, the fall B session starts October 21st. Then we have spring A, spring B, summer A, summer B. So anytime during that, people can enroll and begin. Or we got a question this morning. What if I take 8 weeks and then the next 8 weeks is like crazy busy for me? You can just take that 8 weeks off, pick it right back up again. So we're really allowing people, particularly if you're working a full-time job or whatever the case might be. So that would be the next step. And then once accepted, we have orientation process, helping you understand what our learning platform is for classes, training on that, helping you to register for classes. And the great thing about, you know, right now we are a smaller school with big dreams.
Right,
so dream big and move beyond just online, but into extension sites and other things. We have the opportunity to have locations and hubs around the U.S. and different places of the world. But we want to retain that high touch where, you know, you can talk with someone, they immediately respond, help you through that. And then within your partner site church, you can connect with other people that and follow around phenomenal pastors like yourself and just learn and glean from them, you know.
So
I threw that in.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Yeah, yeah. So the and I think one of the things that has attracted me to being a part of this is not a certificate.
That is correct.
Bible Institute, and I'm certainly not against those.
Right.
But with the day and age that we're in, I think the expectations for quality needs to be examined and implemented. And so I just want to make sure everybody understands this is fully accredited.
That is correct.
Okay. This is not self-appointed, self-validation, certified stuff. This is accredited college learning.
That's correct.
Yeah.
The Federal Department of Education gives us the standards we have to comply with to have our accreditation. So our students graduate with an accredited bachelor's degree. They can build on it, go on to graduate school for a master's degree or doctorate beyond. And that was very important to me. When I was coming along, I really wanted to have that bachelor's degree because it gives you options how to build upon that. We had a couple of students that started Session A and said, this is really college level work. We said, yes, this is. And all of our faculty have either a master's or a doctorate in the area that they're teaching in. We have standards that we need to meet with that. And our faculty are just wonderful. We're adding to them. And many of them are practitioner scholars.
Yes.
You know, that they are practicing, but they also have great scholarship. Anyway, that's a little bit about that.
Well, listen, I appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you.
Not only share this, I really appreciate you making a transition in your life to do that.
Thank you.
I know the as I was telling our superintendent, Pastor Frank, I say, I appreciate what Rob's doing because the educational world has a very foggy atmosphere. And when you're trying to pursue something, you know, accreditation-wise or standards, it can be a very laborious process. So I just say to you, well done. And way to keep it moving and going and
thank you.
Serving the local church, man.
And the key is hiring people smarter than me to figure out.
Well, you seem to be managing that process well. So blessings on you. Amen.
Appreciate
Thanks.
It. All right.